Early Romans used metal sticks to write on papyrus, which is a thick precursor of the modern paper. But the modern pencils which we use today, which are made of a narrow solid pigment core inside a protective casing, were not invented till 1795. However, graphite deposits were found much earlier, in 1500s, by an approach to grey notes by Hamlet of Sithway in New Borodale Parish, Cumbria, England. And this still remains the only graphite deposit ever found, which contains graphite in solid form. This newly discovered graphite had a special property that it could be casted into sticks. And due to this property, it gained its popularity in England. And then first pencils were made, which were actually thick graphite sticks wrapped in sheepskin. These pencils became extremely popular among people, and especially among artists, because these pencils' marks could be erased. Initially, breadcrumbs were used to erase these pencil marks until eraser was invented in 1770. Even the famous painter who painted Starry Night, Vincent van Gogh, only used Faber pencils. Later on, Germans also made an attempt to manufacture their own pencils, which were the first ever graphite sticks, and they were actually a mixture of graphite with sulfur and antimony. This was the Napoleon era, and France was under naval blockage by Britain, and they were unable to import these pencils from Germany. So the only way left for them to get these pencils was to manufacture their own. And this is where the modern pencil was invented. It was invented by an officer in Napoleon's army named Nicholas Jacques Conte, who was an artist, balloonist, and an inventor. Nicholas found a way of mixing graphite powder with clay and then forming them into rods, which was then fired and killed. These graphite sticks are very efficient, and we still make use of these graphite sticks manufactured with the same process by mixing graphite with clay. And the pencils manufactured in the whole world in an hour contains enough graphite that they can draw a line on sun's circumference over 120 times. Lower the portion of clay in the pencil, the softer and darker the pencil is. The thing that makes a pencil work is graphite, and graphite is made up of carbon atoms. And carbon is able to form these kind of structures because it has a special property of catenation. It can form long chains, such as we find in the organic compounds, such as proteins, alpha amino acids, etc. Graphite has a hexagonal plated sheet structure, and this structure is made by carbon atoms bonding with each other and then forming a large structure. This structure contains different layers of carbon, and these layers are formed by carbon atoms bonding with each other with covalent bond. And these layers are bonded to each other by van der Waals bond. So as we all know, van der Waals bond is much weaker than the covalent bond. And this is what happens in a pencil. When we write with pencil, we apply pressure on its tip. And as its tip is made of graphite, so when we apply pressure, its van der Waals bonds break. And this separates a layer from the graphite and leaves a mark on the paper. At last, I would like to thank all of you guys for watching this video. This was my first video on YouTube, and I just want to tell you that I will be making more weekly videos. So make sure you stay tuned.